Been holding this pain inside for so long, though the rain never goes away. They say I should leave these streets behind me, but it's so hard to escape. Oh Lord, please send me an angel to lead me out of this place and take me away.
To be the soldier who never blows his composure, even though I hold the weight of the whole world on my shoulders. I ain't never supposed to show it, my crew ain't supposed to know it. Even if it means going toe to toe with the Benzino, it don't matter. I'd never drag him in battles that I can handle unless I absolutely have to. I'm supposed to set an example, I need to be the leader. My crew looks for me to guide him. If some shit ever just pop off, I'm supposed to be beside him. That job said I tried to squash it, it was too late to stop it. There's a certain line you just don't cross, and he crossed it. I heard him say Haley's name on a song and I just lost it. It was crazy, this shit went way beyond some Jay-Z and Nas shit. And even though the battle was won, I feel like we lost it. I spent so much energy on it, honestly I'm exhausted. And I'm so caught in it, I almost feel I'm the one who caused it. This ain't what I'm in hip-hop for, it's not why I got in it. That was never my object, for someone to get killed. Why would I destroy something I helped build?
Been holding this pain inside for so long, though the rain never goes away. They say I should leave these streets behind me, but it's so hard to escape. Oh Lord, please send me an angel to lead me out of this place and take me away, away, far away to better days.
There used to be a time when you could just say a rhyme and wouldn't have to worry about one of your people dying. But now it's elevated, cause once you put someone's kids in it, the shit gets escalated. It ain't just worse no more, is it? It's a different ballgame. You call names and you ain't just rapping. We actually tried to stop the 50 and Joppy from happening. Me and Dre attacked with him, kicked it and had a chat with him and asked him not to start it. He wasn't gonna go after him until Josh started yapping. In the magazines how he stabbed him. Fuck it, 50, smash him, mash on him, let him have it. Meanwhile, my attention's pulled in another direction. Some receptionist at the source who answers phones at his desk has an erection for me and said I'll be his resurrection. Tries to blow the dust off his mic and make a new record, but now he's fucked the game up. Cause one of the ways I came up was through that publication, the same one that made me famous. Now the owner of it has got a grudge against me for nothing.
Been holding this pain inside for so long, though the rain never goes away. They say I should leave these streets behind me, but it's so hard to escape.
President, and I love that he black, but I'ma ask him like Bush, where the soldiers at? Now move the camera to New Orleans, where the soldiers at? The water dried up, well nigga do the know you clap. We all juveniles, we all been through some trials and some tribulations. I'm in this booth pacing, what do I say next? Should I talk about some cars or the next chapter of my life and show you all my scars, all my bullet wounds and my stab wounds? I can't show you, I cover them up with tattoos. I can't do nothing but spit the truth. On probation, smoking, drink Patron before I hit the booth. You making songs for the club when niggas drinking. I make them for the ride home when niggas stinking. 1 minute you here, next minute shit is tragic.
That we just inherited 50's beef with Murder Inc. And he's inherited mine, which is fine. Ain't like either of us mine. We still have soldiers that's on the front line, that's willing to die for us as soon as we give the orders. Never to extort us, strictly to show they support us. And maybe shout them out in a rapper up in a chorus to show them we love them back and let them know how important it is to have Runyon Avenue soldiers up in our corners. The loyalty to us is worth more than any award is. But I ain't trying to have none of my people heard or murdered, it ain't worth it. I can't think of a perfect way to word it than to just say that I love y'all too much to see the verdict. I walk away from it all before I let it go any further. But don't get it twisted, it's not a plea that I'm copping. I'm just willing to be the bigger man if y'all can quit popping off at your jaws with a knocking. Cause frankly, I'm sick of talking. I'm not gonna let someone else's coffin rest on my conscience. Cause
I've been holding this pain inside for so long.